Hello, friend. It's been some time since I made a video, and this video is going to be along a little bit of a different track. I'm going to explain why I think it's important to meditate, why I meditate, and then I'm going to make a few videos that will be guided meditations. We'll see how that all goes. If you're watching this video, then you probably have a little bit of an interest in meditation. Maybe you've tried to meditate. And maybe you tried and it felt lousy. Like it was just really, really boring, really overly disciplined. And if that's the case, what you want to keep in mind here is that meditation is really just a relaxed but alert state. So it's a state that we often get into without trying. We go for a walk and we get into a relaxed, alert state. We go in nature and we get into a relaxed, alert state. Often what we do is we just do a few simple breaths to get into a nice alert. The breaths help to give you energy. And the breaths also relax your body. So you're kind of brought into your body. So when you're meditating, it's an inward looking. You're becoming familiar with the contents of your mind. And so that means you have a better understanding. You develop a better understanding, a better ability to observe your thoughts and your feelings and all the sensations in your body. And learning how to do this has a lot of really important benefits. And that's what I want to talk to you about now. Why is it that I meditate? What are the reasons? What benefits does meditation give me? Usually when we eat food, we do it while we're sitting down. Right? And it's kind of a rest time for us. Right? And that really allows our body to digest that food, to make all those nutrients a part of our body. So there's this time of digestion that we need when we eat food. But the same is true for every other experience in our life. So if we study physics, we need some quiet time to digest that information, to make those skills part of who we are. So what I'll often see with students is they don't have this digestion time. They don't have this meditation time. And so what they're always trying to do is memorize. So when you're memorizing something, it's like it's not part of you. You're trying to pull something into you. But what you really want to do is make those skills a part of you so that they come naturally to you. So there isn't this big effort all the time when you're doing physics. It's just something that rolls. And that's true of any activities that we do. If we go out and exercise, professional athletes will talk about how important that period of rest is after the exercise. Because once again, they have to digest that experience. That experience has to become part of their body. The cells in their body, the neurons in their brain, they need to make those changes so that that experience becomes part of who they are. So that's the first reason I think meditation is really important, because it allows us to digest our experiences and make those experiences part of who we are. When we meditate, of course, we're looking inwards and we begin to become familiar with all of our thoughts and our emotions and all the bodily sensations that are taking place inside of us. And that added awareness, that added familiarity is very powerful. So in the same way that we don't notice the air around us and we don't notice our own breathing generally, when we become conscious of our breathing, we learn that it can do all kinds of great things. We can energize our body with our breathing. We can direct our breath to different areas of our body. So something we often do in yoga is to do a stretch, and then we breathe into the place that we're stretching, and we find that that relaxes the muscles and we're able to stretch the muscles quite a bit further. So anything that we bring our awareness to, we become familiar with, and that gives us a lot more conscious control. So we get into a situation where we can now play with our thoughts and our emotions and our bodily sensations. We become much more in control, much more a part of our inner world. And that's really, really important and really, really powerful. So as we become more and more familiar with our thoughts and our feelings and all of these bodily sensations, we begin to see the underlying patterns. So we begin to recognize that there's all these stories that we tell ourselves. And these stories, they kind of guide, they're what our thoughts emanate from. And we might be telling ourselves stories that are really restricting us, really stopping us from doing well. Or we might be telling ourselves stories that make us very strong and courageous. And once you become more and more aware of the stories that you're telling yourself, then you can become much more able to change those stories and change the thoughts and feelings and sensations in your body that you experience. What's more, as you see these patterns, you begin to see yourself a little bit differently. You become more connected to what is it you're really attracted to? What are kind of your rhythms? What is kind of your essence? So you become much more familiar with yourself as a whole and much more true to yourself in that sense. Another thing that I really like about meditation is it's like these series of really gentle but fundamental exercises for your mind. So for instance, you might focus your awareness on your breath as it comes into and out of your nostrils. So you're keeping your focus quite tight. But of course, your thoughts come and you drift away. And then you gently bring your awareness back to your nostril and your breath. And that trains you. You keep doing that again and again and again. And that trains you to be able to keep your focus where you want it to be, so you can focus on the things that you really want in life. Or another thing we do in meditation is to bring our awareness to the different areas of our body. So we can bring our awareness to our baby finger, or we bring our awareness to our nose or our forehead or our chest or our shoulder. And we can shift it from place to place. So that gives our mind much more flexibility in terms of being able to focus on one thing and then the next. What's another thing that we do in meditation is to use our imagination. So for instance, I can imagine a wave of green energy coming from my heart into my baby finger. And maybe that feels pretty good for my baby finger. Or I can imagine that my body is hollow. Or I can imagine that I am aware of the space around me. There's so many different things that we can do. And this comes out in a lot of the guided meditations. But you end up really training your imagination and trusting your imagination and learning the great effects that your imagination has on you and the great power of your imagination. Summarizing, meditation helps us to digest experiences. It helps us to familiarize ourselves with the contents of our mind and the stories that we tell ourselves so that we're able to change those stories. It allows us to develop better, more penetrating focus. It helps us develop the ability to shift our focus in a flexible way, and it helps us to develop our imagination. I know from personal experience that meditation works, because just 4 years ago in 2020, I retired. I moved to a remote village with my wife and my handicapped daughter, who has autism and Down syndrome. A few months later, my wife got cancer, and then she died in 2022. I then met a woman and moved to a new city where I didn't know anybody to be with this woman. And I got dumped a few months later. And because of meditation, and really meditation and yoga, it was the best thing that ever happened to me. That I've been able to turn all of those experiences around. And even my relationship with my daughter has become so much better. So I recommend meditation, and I'm very grateful for what meditation has done for me.